Today we are going to discuss about a scenario, okay? So where I have a array of integers, okay, and the other input I get is a target number, okay? So I need to find out all the pairs of numbers in within my array, okay? So if I sum up those two pairs, I need to get my target. So I need to find out all those pairs of numbers from this array. So that is a scenario, okay? So when we try to resolve this problem, okay, what we normally do is like we first of all get one for loop to iterate from 8 to 4, and the other for loop to iterate from the next integer to here. So then we add these two and 8 plus 7, 8 plus 1, 8 plus 0. Similarly, like once we are done with 8, then 3 plus 7, 3 plus 1, 3 plus 0. So this you can do that, but what is the drawback of that is like the runtime complexity is getting increased, right? Like in case you have millions of numbers, then it is O of n square, so of course you will be consuming more time, okay? So there is other way to resolve this issue, okay? Here what I'm doing is I'm creating a set, okay? What I'll be adding in this set is like whenever like I'm getting a number for the first time, I'll be adding the set. Like let's get into it, right? Or for example, like I'm getting 8, okay? And I'm checking, okay, the target minus the 8, right, which is minus 1, whether it is there in the set, right? It is not there. Then what I'm doing, I'm adding 8, okay? Similarly, the 3, right? 3 is also the target. 3 my 7 minus 3 is 4, which is not there, okay? So here, okay, 7 minus 7, 0, which is not there, right? And when I come here, okay, 7 minus 0 is 7, which is there, right? So in that case, I'm taking that as a pair and I'm printing it. Here, the advantage in this approach is, okay, the runtime complexity is just 0 of n. Just I need to go from the first to last, that's all, okay? And, but I'm consuming a space, the space complexity may be more because I'm creating one more set which will be storing the uniqueness of some of these numbers, right? So that's other cons of this approach, but the advantage is like it will run very fast, okay? So if you have a good memory, then it's a best approach. Let me run this. So these are the different combinations for a target to reach 7, right?